कृष्ण कृष्ण चैतन्य नान्य गौर
manager at that time.
elastic arm. In a present world, John Gibson Dunn, mother wife, old man, then management will be collapsed. He managed everything. Then, by the great wisdom of elastic arm, it is. But if he lost, then he was dead. He told, oh, you know, given you first sentence, but you are not taking, just take sentence. And then finally saw this from the train. He had once went to Siddhartha Maharaj and he selected this time. He stood Mathura, Avacharananda Prabhu, he came, thanked him in the lodge, and his son, wife and family man, they told him, no use of your wedding. And they explained from their houses. You know that he has not come for all these things. So, when he was establishing Bengal for Kabila after that in Allahabad, and he searched first. But he said, then mentors of me were Jawaharlal Nehru, Indian Prime Minister first, the daughter, Indira Gandhi, who is born. But by chance he also was. Then he knew so many medicines, his own, and he began to distribute, but it was also felt. When everything felt, then he came to Mathura, and he was anywhere near this temple. I heard that he had come to Mathura, and he is giving the medicine here and there as a agent. Then I said, could be happy, and myself was lost. That please come here. What are you doing now? Then he, by request, he came to our Mathura. I gave him a room just near my room, and he began to be here. Now I told him that you are very qualified. And you are the mercy of Siddha Prabhupada. So don't try to be Grihastha now. Give up all these things and take Yeah.
Thank you. And this is the Krishna consciousness movement, and this this grudge lefty, they're not actually members of ISKCON. Because the real member of ISKCON, who has love and affection, who has grief, he can never fall down. If anybody's fallen down, or if he's already fallen and trying to rise, he can't really be a member of ISKCON. He can only be a member of ISKCON, of us, or a semblance of ISKCON. So, Srila Gurdi, what's our Srila Prabhupada?
Saying this is the definition of ISKCON.
That is, this verse, Krishna Bhakti Ras, Bhakti Ras Bhavi Bhakti. Now Srila Prabhupada also quotes the same thing. He explained to us right from the beginning, right in 1966, in our first ISKCON temple in New York City, at 26 Second Avenue, that Srila Rupa Goswami explained in his Padyavali that if Krishna consciousness is available anywhere, then you should purchase it without delay. And what is that price? The anxiety to have it. In 1968, he quoted the verse, and he said that Mati means intelligence or status of mind. What status of mind? That I would serve Krishna under any circumstance. On the level of Srimati Radhika, even when there's some sunstones, very sharp stones that burn the feet like fire on Govardhan, she'll stand on those stones because they give her a very good vantage point to see Krishna. So she happily stands on them. So I would serve Krishna under any circumstance. This is the definition of ISKCON, how I quoted that verse. If you can purchase that status of mind under any circumstance, anywhere, then purchase it immediately. Then Srila Gurudev explained that anyone who's not following on this level, he may try to be an ISKCON, but really he's only an ISKCON of us. Then, the word Bhakti Vedanta, Srila Gurudev often says that people who claim to be Prabhupada Yuga are not actually followers of our Srila Prabhupada, but those who follow in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami, in his line of disciplic succession, with the proper feeling, the proper vow, the proper sentiments, and proper activities, they are actually members of ISKCON. So he said, don't think that you're Prabhupada Yuga, think that you're Rupa Yuga, and actually be Rupa Yuga. So similarly, the word Bhakti Vedanta applies to all those, not only to Prabhupada, but to those who are actually Rupa Yuga. And the Prabhupada himself explains that in the very first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. He says, in relation to Narada Muni serving the Bhaktivedantas, that is the four Kumaras, our Srila Prabhupada writes, as such, the Vedanta bodies, or those who are followers of Vedanta, or the Bhakti Vedanta, who are impartial in distributing transcendental knowledge of the disciplic succession, to them, no one is a friend and no one is an enemy. No one is educated and no one is uneducated. No one is favorable and no one is unfavorable. The Bhakti Vedantas see people in general as wasting their time in sensuous things. Their business, the business of the Bhakti Vedantas, as the sannyas line of Srila Bhakti Pragyanesh Gosai Maharaj, is Bhakti Vedanta. Srila Bhakti Vedanta Brahman Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Pranayan Goswami Maharaj, Śrī Bhakti Vedanta Trivika Goswami Maharaj, Śrī Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. So their business, Bhakti Vedanta, is to get the ignorant mass of people to re-establish the lost relationship with the personality of Godhead. By such endeavor, even the most forgetful souls are roused to a sense of spiritual life, and thus, initiated by the Bhakti Vedantas, the people in general gradually progress on the path of spiritual realization. So often, our Śrīla Prabhupāda said that people give me credit for starting the Krishna consciousness movement in the West, but I haven't started it at all. The actual establisher is Lord Brahma. Then it was passed to Narada, then Vyas, then Madhva, then down to Madhavanapuri, then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then the Goswami, and so on. And I am just the representative. And Śrīla Gurudeva also says that our Śrīla Prabhupāda is not the founder acharya of the eternal Islam, which our Śrīla Prabhupāda says in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. In the ninth chapter, the tree of devotional service is described. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the whole tree. But he says, how can I distribute the fruit of love of God? So therefore, the trunk and the roots and the branches and the sub-branches, they all assist him in distributing the fruits of love of God. And there, our Śrīla Prabhupāda writes that our ISKCON movement is one of the branches of the eternal tree of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And as Śrīla Gurudeva also often states, our Śrīla Prabhupāda is a great arm of Śrīla Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So why did our Śrīla Prabhupāda insist on saying on certain occasions to his disciples that I am the founder of Acharya of ISKCON? It's because ISKCON is a homonym. There is eternal ISKCON, and then there is the corporate ISKCON that Śrīla Prabhupāda did found in order to manage a worldwide institution. There's one letter where he states, your idea of, this is to one of his disciples, your idea of forming a trust between ISKCON and the leading Indians is approved by me. That is very nice. Let them take part in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. Now, in that trust, you should be very careful that my name is registered as founder acharya, and I am the ultimate authority. In other words, in cases of veto or canceling any decision made by other trustees, I should be able to do so. My decision should rule over all other trustees combined. So in this homonym, the necessity of management and maintaining buildings and so on and so forth for legal matters, if this is done, our Śrīla Prabhupāda is the founder of acharya. Otherwise, he is a very prominent link in the realism. Śrīla Gurudeva, in one very beautiful lecture in Willowbar in 2000, stated very nicely, your Prabhupada, Śrīla Swami Maharaj, only changed the name into English. He is not the founder of acharya of the eternal ISKCON. I am also ISKCON. I am not different from this kind. I am Bhaktivedanta, that is Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj, like father, like son. I am the real successor of Śrīla Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and there is no other. You should know this very openly. I am Bhaktivedanta, and he is Bhaktivedanta. But he received the name after I did. So I'm senior to him in Bhaktivedanta. I am also ISKCON. Don't think that I am out of ISKCON. Shukra Dev said, at the time of Shukra Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, gives the precedent, as you may know, the founder of Charya then at the time of Shukra Rupa Goswami, they became Vishva Vaishnava Raj Sabha under the presidency of Shukra Jiva Goswami. Then being passed down the line, it became Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, and the founder of that is Nityananda Vishnu Alma Srinivas Goda Sri Srimachalokhi Pragyan, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, our Paramurti. And the three original members of that society, Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, is Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, I think Madhusudananda, or who's the other? Oh, Srila Bhakti Maharaj. Srila Bhakti Vedanta Vaman Goswami Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada. And then he took that Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti and brought it to the West, at which time it became known as ISKCON. So actually, who was ISKCON? Narada Muni, Prahlad, and most particularly, Srila Rupa Goswami and the Rupa Nupa. What is the essence of that? As you know, there's a book that only advanced devotees should read, and that is called Krishna Bhavanamrita, which contains the confidential pastimes of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna, their daily pastimes. So what does Srila Prabhupada say about Krishna Bhavanamrita in relation to this kind? He says,
even if I have to take birth, I'm not asking to not
says, my attraction for the holy name in Greek, that's my main prayer. And secondly, our Srila Prabhupada says that our Islam movement is really called Krishna Bhavanamrita Sangha, because we are not interested in liberation or anything from Krishna, even if we have to take birth, just like what Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, in any species, it's fine. Then Prabhupada in the Krishna book mentions the book, Krishna Bhavanamrita, that there is a book by Srila Viswanatha Chakravarti Thakur, wherein all of the associates are fully absorbed in thinking of Krishna and his pastimes. When Krishna went to Mathura, all the residents of Vrindavan went mad thinking of him. This was their whole life being absorbed in separation from Krishna. Similarly, so one should read this book in order to increase his feeling of separation from Krishna. Just like this Krishna book will do that, and just like our teachings of Lord Chaitanya will do that. So one who wants to feel separation of Krishna, like the Prajapatis and like the Gopis, they should read this Krishna Bhavanamrita, which is the real meaning of Islam. So all glories to our Srila Prabhupada, and all glories to Srila Gurudev, the two members of his family who are from heaven, and their children.
First of all, I'd like to offer my hear everyone over here. Anything but me.
Thank you.
this day of Vishnu Mahotsava, Mahamahotsava. It is a day of, especially for us devotees who come from the West, it is a day of remembering and appreciating the causeless mercy of our beloved Srila Prabhupada, who came to save us, who came to give us this wonderful gift of the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna Prem. And on this day, we are remembering him, but we are also remembering his contemporaries whom he associated with before he came to the West. Those personalities who also played a very prominent role in his life, and also in our lives. As so nicely described by Vrindavani Lasini, how Srila Prabhupada came and knocked on everyone's door and danced in every town and village, giving this wonderful message of Krishna Prem to all. But also, we now have more information, especially from the book of Mula Prakriti Didi, showing us so many relationships that Srila Prabhupada had before he came to the West, and how important those relationships were. But amongst those relationships, especially with his senior god-brothers, and very exalted movement of the Vaishnavas, he had a very intimate relationship with them. And on this day, we particularly remember the relationship that he had with our Param Gurudev, it's a little permission to Srila Bhakti Pradhyana Keshav Goswami Maharaj. And also with our beloved Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Because, and also, yes, with the Tadila permission to Srila Bhakti Rakshak Srinara Maharaj. Because all of these personalities have a very important connection in relation to his. In relation to his preparing himself to go to the West in the 40s and 50s, Srila Bhakti Rakshak Srinara Maharaj lived for very many years, nearly 10 years, in Srila Prabhupada's house in Calcutta. And at that time, they exchanged so many intimate realizations of Krishna consciousness. Our Srila Prabhupada has told that fact. And he said that Krishna liked him to prepare me. So in this way, there was a very divine connection between these exalted Paramahansa, Mahabhava Vaishnavas. And actually, Srila Sridhar Maharaj remembers that toward the end of our Prabhupada's household life, as Srila Gurudev was describing, as he had a dream one night, and that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada came to him and told him to take sannyas. And immediately when he came downstairs, he spoke this to Srila Sridhar Maharaj. And he discussed it with him. And he was actually very anxious to immediately do this. But Srila Sridhar Maharaj told him, wait some time. This is written in the book of Mula Prakriti Didi, directly conversation with Srila Sridhar Maharaj. And a couple of weeks later, again, the same dream came. And that time when the dream came, again, he came downstairs and again spoke to Srila Maharaj. And then they talked for some time. And Srila Maharaj also was advising him to wait for some time. But after that, he was left. He was gone. So from that point in time, we previously did not know where Prabhupada went,
who he associated with. But more pieces of the puzzle fit together, and especially Srila Prabhupada has explained to us how he came then to Mathura. We never knew this before, that he came to Mathura and then our Srila